ॐ सहनाववतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिः। Namaste friends, welcome to all for preparation of NET yoga exam. I am here with you to discuss the 2018 July previous question paper from 76 to 100. Myself Naresh Katla, I qualified as assistant professor in 2017. I did masters from SVSI University. Let's move on question number 76. Arrange the following group of vertebrae in descending order according to position in body. Okay, sacral vertebrae, lumbar vertebrae, cervical vertebrae, thoracic vertebrae. So first is come cervical vertebrae C, and next is the thoracic, then lumbar, then sacral. So C D, this is the right answer. So one more questions you can make, and getting the whole concept about the spinal cord and number of bones. So posterior region of the body is total 33 bones are present in vertebrae, which are, I am going to show in clear in picture. Let's see in that an image. This is the vertebrae. It's a small, this total first 7 cervical vertebras, next 12 thoracic vertebras, next 5 lumbar vertebrae, and next 5 sacrum, which are fused together, and next is a coccyx, 3 is fused together. So total 33 bones in spinal cord. And one more question also you can guess in upcoming exam, that is a spinal nerves. So spinal nerves also presents total 31 pairs of the spinal nerves. So with this order also same and name also same. Just you can add the here 7 cervical vertebrae, you can just 8 cervical spinal nerves and 12 thoracic spinal nerves as it is, and 5 lumbar and 5 sacrum, and coccyx is the one pair only. So total 31 pair of the spinal nerves. Okay friends, let's move on next question. Arrange the following stage in sequential order according to Bhagavad Gita. Option A, attachment. Option B, anger. Option C, desire. Option D, thinking about worldly matters. So first it will come thinking about the worldly matter, D. Option D, where is D? Yes, you can directly go D. And next is attachment. Next after desire, if you not fulfill the desire, the anger will come. The end product is anger. End one is anger. First is thinking about the world matter, then attachment, you get the some attachment through the, that particular kind of object. So you get, once getting idea about object, you want to desire, you want to get in, you want to acquire that object, you want that object. If you not get that object, then you will be frustrated, anger. So option number 2 is the right answer. Let's move on next question. match the following question. Samatvam yoga ucchate, yoga chitta vritti nirodha, yoga karmausu kaushalam, dukkha sanyoga viyoga, yoga sanyanitam. Okay, samatvam yoga ucchate is the second chapter, 48th sloka is a karma yoga, and yoga chitta vritti nirodha is a yoga sutra. So, and yoga karmausu kaushalam, and second chapter, 58th sloka, dukkha sanyoga viyoga yoga sanyanitam is the sixth chapter, 23rd sloka. So samatvam yoga ucchate is the option number 2 is the right answer. So 3 is the right answers. Okay, as a yoga sadhaka, as a yoga student, as a yoga disciple and learning of yoga, you should know the at least 5 to 6 definitions of the yoga and with the reference of the sloka number also. So I'm going to giving the total clear definition of the sloka. So let's see that. This is yogastu kuru karmani sanyam tyaktva dhananjaya siddha asiddhyo samo bhutva samatvam yoga ucchate. The next sloka, buddhi yukto janahi jahatita ube sukrito duskrute duskruta sukruta duskrute tasmad yogaya yujyasva yogaha karmosu kaushalam. And next, tam vidyad dukkha samyoga viyoga yoga samyatam. So this is a 3 slokas taken from the Bhagavad Gita, and next is that is from the Patanjali Yoga Sutra, very famous sloka. So yoga chitta vritti nirodha. Okay, let's move on next question. Match the following. Satkaryavada, Vivartavada, Syadavada, Kshanamanguravada. This all vyada is related to creation and causation, creation of the world. How the world is created and what is there, this theory about. So Satkaryavada is Sankhya, is Sankhya, and Vivartavada is Vedanta, and Syadavada is Jainism, and Kshanabhangura is the Buddhism. So this is the right answer. So Satkaryavada, you can check option number 2. So option number 3 is the right answer. Okay, let's see the little bit more information about this in this slide. Satkaryavada is a Sankhya theory of caution, also called as a Prakritya Parinama Vada. Okay, Prakriti Parinama Vada. And Vivartavada is a Vedanta theory. Caution is given by Shankaracharya. It's a Brahma and Maya. And Syadavada, Jaina metaphysics. It is also called as Anekantavada. Many sides of the reality about this world. And next is a Kshanabhanguravada, is a Buddhism. Nothing is permanent. Kshanabhangura. Kshana means nothing is permanent. Okay, friends. Let's move on. Next question. Match the following again. Jagruti Vasta, Supna Vasta, Shushupti Vasta, Turiya Vasta. So Jagruti Vasta is a first Akara, and Supna Vasta is a Ukara, and Shushupti Vasta is them. So sorry, this is Jagruti Vasta is Akara. Sushupti Vasta is Makara, and Turiya Vasta is Amatra. Okay, so it's behind the Omkara state. Okay, this is the right answer. So you can choose the options. Jagruti Vasta is the 3, and Swapna Vasta is the 1, and next is Sushupta Vasta is the 4. 3, 1, 4. So option number 3 is the right answer. This is from the Mandukya Upanishad, the smallest Upanishad among the 10 Upanishads. Okay, 10 famous Upanishads. Let's move on next question. Tattva Vaisharadi, Yoga Vartika, Maniprabha, Yoga Sudhakara. These are the text. This and who is the author of the respective texts? Who written the text is given here. Ramananda Yeti, Vachaspati Mishra, Sadashivendra Saraswati, Vijnana Bhikshu. So, Tattva Vaisharadi is this is the text is written by Vachaspati Mishra. Yoga Vartika is the Vijnana Bhikshu and Maniprabha Sadananda Saraswati and Yoga Sudhakara Ramananda Yeti. Okay friends, this is the right answer. Let's see. Tattva Vaisar Vachaspasmita Yoga Vartya Vijnana Bhikshu Commentary on Yoga Bhasha Yoga Sutra with Maniprabha Ramananda Yoga Sutra with Maniprabha. Yoga Sutra with Maniprabha is Ramananda Saraswati. Okay. I confused here. So this is not. And Maniprabha is a Ramananda Yeti. Okay. Ramananda. Maniprabha is the Ramananda Yeti. Yoga Sudhakara. Is a Sadananda Saraswati. Okay. So option number Tattva Vaisharada Vachaspati Mishra 2. So option number 2 is the right answer. Let's move on next question. Match the following. Aparavairagya Kriya Yoga Paravairagya Asampragnata Samadhi. So here Aparavairagya Paravairagya and Aparavairagya. So, apara vairagya make us to kaivalya. Kriya yoga kleshtanu karana. Para vairagya. Sampragnata samadhi. Asampragnata samadhi. Kaivalya. Paravairagya is Asampragnata Samadhi. No, Aparavairagya is Asampragnata Samadhi. Paravairagya Asampragnata Samadhi. Asampragnata Kriya Yoga is Klesha Tanukarana. Paravairagya is Asampragnata Samadhi. And Asampragnata Samadhi makes to Kaivalya. Okay, so option number 4 is the right answer. Let's move on next question. Jnana Yoga Samadhi, Nada Yoga Samadhi, Rasananda Samadhi, Laya Siddhi Samadhi. So Jnana Yoga Samadhi by Shambhavi Mudra 3. And Nada Yoga Samadhi is the Brahmari Mudra. Here mentioned Mudra is the Ran. So Brahmari is the Pranayama. And Rasananda Samadhi is the Kechari Mudra. Laya Siddhi is the Yoni Mudra. So according to this, Jnana Yoga Samadhi is the 2. So option number 2 is the right answer, but here mentioned Mudra, so that's why in UGC NET given marks for everyone, but here should mention Pranayama. Let's move on next question. So these are the total 6 Samadhis are mentioned in Garanda Samhita. First is Jnana Samadhi is attained through the Shambhavi Mudra. Nada Yoga Samadhi attained through the Brahmari Pranayama. Rasananda Samadhi attained through the Kechari Mudra. Laya Siddhi Samadhi through the Yoni Mudra. Bhakti Yoga Samadhi attained through the devotional activity. And Raja Yoga Samadhi attained through the Mano Murcha Pranayama. Okay friends, let's move on next question. Anderson and Gardner, Stenberg and Sissy. Question number 84. Answer is the theory of intelligence. Theory of intelligence. Gardner is the theory of multiple intelligence. Sternberg is the practic theory of intelligence. And CC is the biological theory of intelligence. So option number 1 is the right answer. Let's move on next. Vitamin B1, vitamin B2, vitamin B12, vitamin B3. So the vitamin B1, beriberi. So the vitamin B1, you get the beriberi disease. Vitamin B1, beriberi. And so beriberi. And vitamin B2, you get the angular stomatitis. B12, you get the megaloblastic anemia, and B3, pellagra. Okay, so option number 4 is the right answer. Let's move on next question. These are the all the A and B and up to total 12 vitamins. A, B1, B2, B3. If you consider these only one, B having so many categories, total 7 categories. So B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, B7, B8, B9 and B12. Okay, these are the respective diseases. If you deficiency of the vitamin A, night blindness, and vitamin C, scurvy, vitamin D, rickets and osteomalacia, and vitamin E, less fertility, vitamin K, non-clotting of blood. Next question, 86th, obesity, cervical spondylosis, diabetes and pregnancy. Obesity, Naukasana is the best. Obesity, Naukasana best. Cervical spondylosis, Bhujangasana is the best. Diabetes, Ardhamachandrasana. And pregnancy, Tithilasana is the good. So, and for this 86th, option number 2 is the right answer. Let's move on. 87, Neti, Dauti, Basti, Trataka. So, if you practice the Neti, the Jaturdva Roga will, the related to eye disorder will be eradicated. Through the Dauti, the Swasa, breathing related problem. Through the Basti practices Gulma, the constipation and large intestine anus related problems will be, excretory system related problem will go out. And Trataka, by practicing Tratakam, Tandra Roga. Okay friends, so Neti 2 and Dauti, Swasa, and Basti is a Gulma. So option number 4 is the right answer. So next, lecture method, group discussion method, demonstration method, directed practice method. Lecture method is a formal teaching. Lecture is a formal teaching, and group discussion method for solution. Group discussion for solution. Demonstration method is assignment, and direct practice method is for skill. So 88, option number 3 is the right answer. So direct practice method is assignment. Direct practice method is assignment. So once again, lecture method is the formal teaching. Group discussion for the solution, and demonstration method for skill. Direct practice method for assignment. So option number 3 is the right answer. Let's move on. Paragraph based questions. Try to read the, just pause the video and read everything. Let's move on direct question. Which of the following is not type of pranayama? Bahyavritti, sambhavritti, manovritti, abhyantara vritti. So manovritti is not as a pranayama. Which of the sixth limb of yoga as described in Maharshi Patanjali? Sixth limb, yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, dharana is the sixth limb. And by the practice of which of the following limb yoga person does not get easily affected by duality? So by practicing avasana, not get the duality. Practice of withdrawing the sense from contact with external object is called as a, is the pratyahara. Okay friends, let's move on next. Practice of withdrawing the sense from the contact with external object is called as pratyahara. Again repeated question. And the covering of overlight of knowledge get removed by practicing a pranayama. Okay, let's move on last questions. Try to read this paragraph, just pause the video and read the paragraph. Second International Yoga Day was celebrated on 1st 2015, then 21st June 2016. The theme of international conference organized in 21st and 22nd June 2016 was Yoga for Body and Mind, Body and Behind. 96th Yoga for Body and Behind. So this is the theme. During the first International Day of Yoga, how many participants and nationality participated in single yoga session? So total 84 national will participated and 35,985 participated during that day in from India only. Only India. So option number 1 is the right answer. Let's move on. 193 member UNGA approved the proposal of established 21st June as the International Day of Yoga on September 27, 2014, September 11, 2014, December 27, 2014, December 11, 2014. So December 27, 2014. Okay. Just read that paragraph carefully. How many Divyangas performed yoga protocol during the second International Yoga Day of Yoga? So how many total? 150 Divyangas. Divyanga means is them who are Angavaikilya. Yoga does not embody unity of mind and body, man and nature, thought and action, thought and dream. Okay friends, thank you friends. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and give your valuable feedback in a comment box, and press along with the bell icon. You get the all the notification when I uploaded the new videos. Suggestions are most welcome. Thank you very much.